Hello, this is Klaus Jensen presenting a miniature game that finished only yesterday on ICCF. Normally you don't see games like this one in correspondence chess, because this game looks more like a game played 100 years ago when chess was all about attacking and most players were defending pretty badly. So please fasten your seatbelt, because this one is fast and furious, and I'm playing the white pieces and we're having a Ruy Lopez. And in the third move, my opponent played knight d4. I never recall having seen this move before. I think it's called the bird's defense. I'm not quite sure, but what I'm sure of is that it's not the best way to play against the Ruy Lopez. Knight takes, e takes, and the castles, and black is already behind in development, and a slightly worse pawn structure. Bishop c5. At this point, I had to decide whether to go for calm development and play for a small plus, which would normally be my choice. I could play something like d3, c6, preparing d5 with tempo, bishop a4, knight e7, knight d2, castles, and then I could play, for example, f4, knight f3, this kind of plan, or I could play something like c3, and then play for a d4 advance at some point to have control of the center. This would be the calm option. But I thought that let's have some fun in this game, and I played b4. This is exactly the same pawn sack idea as in the Evans Gambit, which is from the Italian game. The idea here is to deflect the bishop away from controlling d4, and then we can play c3 later with tempo, chasing away the bishop again, and then we have we can get this open position, control of the center, and the c pawn, bishop can go to b2 or to a3. So bishop takes b4, bishop b2, bishop c5, c3, d takes, and knight takes c3, and I'm down a pawn, of course, but I have a very promising position, I'd say. My three light pieces are ready for attack, my two bishops and this knight, and the most important thing important things. I have a nice control of the center. I can play d4, and the most important thing is probably that the black king is still stuck in the center. He hasn't castled yet, and this is very important, as we shall see in the game. c6, black wants to prepare d5 with tempo, and in this position both bishop c4 and also d4 has been tried before, but I wanted action, so I played the hyper-aggressive knight d5. The main point of this move is, of course, that it opens up for attacks on g7, and other points here are that if black takes the bishop on b5, then bishop takes g7, d6, and bishop takes h takes h8, winning the exchange. So this g7 threat was to be taken seriously, and the same goes if my opponent tries to take on d5 instead, then still taking on g7, a6, bishop d3, again winning the exchange. So best defense is probably knight f6, but then after knight takes, g takes, bishop c4, black cannot really castle kingside anymore, so he will have to try to castle queenside at some point, but this will take several moves, and I think whenever I start playing my queen to h5, hitting f7, and also possibly hitting f6 at some point, then black will be very busy protecting his pawns on in the f-file and trying to castle at the same time, so I have a nice advantage here. But in the game, my opponent didn't play knight f6, he played bishop f8, which seems to be okay, because he solves the problem with g7. This is protected now. Of course, he has no development at all. All his pieces are still on the back rank, but it seems that he can get away with this, because he has a fork on my two light pieces here. So apparently he has a good position. But now comes a real power move, queen h5. And now the point is that c takes b5 here, then queen e5 check, knight e7, knight c7, and black loses his queen. So that doesn't work. And if knight f6 here, then knight takes f6, g takes, bishop c4, and you can see I have put some arrows here. I have a huge attack here. I have threats on f7. The f6 pawn is also a problem for black. I can play e5 and rook a to e1, and I'm simply having a big advantage here. So that doesn't work. So my opponent took the knight instead on d5, and I took back, and now I have sacked this this knight, but in exchange I have the open e-file. And since the black king is still stuck in the center, this e-file is proving to be too much for my opponent. Queen b6, rook a to e1, check, knight e7. Oh, here, bishop e7, then would follow bishop takes g7, and then taking on b5, take the rook on h8, queen b6, then we have a very nice rook takes e7, knight takes, and rook e1, and this e-file is proving too much for black. But he didn't play bishop e7, he played knight e7, and then this bishop that has been attacking this g7 pawn, this g7 pawn is now sufficiently protected, so now my bishop switches to a3 instead, attacking e7. And if g6 here, then would follow queen e2, again putting a lot of pressure in the e-file. And my opponent decided he could move his king away from the pin in the e-file. And here comes another very nice move, d6, and in this position my opponent resigned. And a line could be knight c6, then taking on f7, and bishop takes d6, bishop takes, queen d4, and then there's a very nice computer move here, rook e6, threatening to take on c6, followed by a queen e7 checkmate. And if d takes e6, then bishop c7 is checkmate. But no matter what, then in this position there's no escape for my opponent, so he decided to resign here. I hope you enjoyed this miniature attacking game, and I hope to see you on my blog at clausjensen.com. Bye bye for now.